Researchers in Israel paired the smell of rotten eggs with cigarettes to form a negative association to help smokers quit while they sleep. And a new aquatic exosuit will help archaeologists explore deep-sea shipwrecks for longer periods of time. It's outfitted with cameras, can be controlled remotely, and is basically like wearing a submarine. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mindflow. ArtHealth is a universal health sensor that allows people to diagnose themselves anywhere. Using a single drop of blood, the device can test for hundreds of lab values, including vitamin D, calcium, and red or white blood cells, by using nanoscale test strips read by laser. NASA helped fund its development to better monitor the health of astronauts, and it uses 1,500 times less blood than conventional lab tests. It recently won the grand prize from XPRIZE, and they say it can help diagnose diseases before you have them, including cancer. Rescue operations could get a huge boost from cyborg cockroaches. Researchers at North Carolina State University are attaching circuit boards and unidirectional microphones to the insects, so they'll be compelled to move towards the sounds of a person struggling or crying for help. An army of these biobots would be released to help first responders gather information in areas they can't initially enter. And cockroaches are ideal candidates because they're small, hard to kill, and do not likely experience feelings of pain. The food and fuel of the future could be grown on highway algae farms. An experimental garden in Switzerland on a viaduct over a small highway uses the unobstructed sunlight and overabundance of CO2 from vehicles to grow algae. Built this summer, it proves how highways could be easily modified to grow food, biofuel, and clean the air. Male bustards are promiscuous birds that may cure their sexually transmitted diseases by eating poisonous beetles. So yeah. Retro-reflective projection technology could make cars see-through. Developed at Keio University in Japan, it uses mirrors, cameras, and fabric lined with tiny glass beads to project outside images inside the car. Aside from eliminating blind spots in your car, it could be used to let pilots see the runway beneath them, create gloves to allow surgeons to see through their hands, or put us one step closer to invisibility cloaks. The Alteros Bat is a wind turbine that floats in the sky. The helium-filled device is designed to reach altitudes of 1,000 feet, where air currents are 5 to 8 times more powerful. Set to debut in Alaska for an 18-month testing period, the Bat will bring power to families living off the grid, while also providing Wi-Fi and cell phone service. Mexican free-tailed bats employ a form of sonar jamming that prevents other bats from catching their food. And the Bertholdia moth jams bats to prevent themselves from becoming food. A lot of jamming. Researchers have devised a mathematical model for white smell, the nasal equivalent to white noise. The formula combines 38 different compounds and so far can cancel out the smell of onion, sauerkraut, fermented tuna, and even the notoriously stinky durian fruit. But right now, no device has been built. This is just math. Smelly math. Rover turns bomb-sniffing dog training into a video game. Using Xbox Kinect, soldiers can communicate with a virtual dog via gestures in order to learn how to correctly lead a bomb-sniffing dog on a hunt for an IED. Practicing virtually is especially important because out in the field, handlers can accidentally untrain their dogs by not being attentive and picking up on the subtle cues from the animals. Finally, researchers at MIT have found a way to get inside their robots' heads. Using ceiling-mounted projectors, animation software, and motion capture technology, they can visualize a robot's intentions in real time.
For example, you can think of a scenario where an agent can communicate with nearby agents, but only within a certain radius of communication. And as this leader agent moves around in its environment, it can link up to other agents and give them tasks to do in real time. This was work that was previously very hard to convey to spectators from outside our lab because it was difficult to ascertain when that communication link occurred. But now, using our system, we can in real time see when that link up occurs.
I'm gonna leave you with a humanoid robot autonomously playing the metallophone, and as always, thanks for watching.